initially we had a tortoise come in that had really bad nasal discharge and was just looking really sick. Cytologically, we took some samples from the nose and you could see these little spiral-shaped bacteria, and we thought that was really weird. So we used some molecular diagnostics to find all kinds of different bacteria, and there was overwhelmingly one dominant bacteria there, and it was in the genus Helicobacter. Initially, that was just kind of a one-off, and we're like, oh, and then we started seeing other tortoises with that. But we don't really know where this bacteria came from. It's a new species, so that, you know, the first time we're finding it is in these tortoises. And the correlation between having this bacteria and being dead in a year is very strong.
The gopher tortoises are super crucial to the environment. They're a keystone species, so they help keep the integrity of the environment, but also help other species, just even with their burrows. So they're very important.
Tortoises are poorly ecologically positioned to deal with infectious diseases because so much of the species is invested in keeping these adult animals alive for a long time, and that's kind of their ecological strategy. Seeing something all of a sudden here in the population that's just strongly correlated with fairly rapid death is a very significant concern for a very important species. Our findings here in Florida probably are applicable to the entire species throughout the Southeast, and a lot of those populations are declining already. And we're early in the process, but the fact that we've also just found the Grand Cayman iguana is a critically endangered species. It was down to 25 animals not long ago. They were suddenly acutely dying, and we identified a closely related but distinct new Helicobacter species in them as well. And the fact that we're seeing two closely related new species that are both associated with death in reptiles tells us that this is potentially having very significant population level effects. And we need to learn a lot more about how does this work? Is there a toxin, or is there some other mechanism that's killing it? And how do we save these animals?